the Warriors sure soared off into the previous postseason sunset. Highlighted by winning 10 of the last 14, then way upsetting East number 4 playoff seed, Scotland County. As much as that 15-11 overall roster raised its game through peaked performance, its heirs have been thrown an overhanging curve. Because every single safety net behind the plate is now absent due to graduation or evacuation. The best defense against such suspense depends on what quality contribution level this backup backstop now reaches. That mitigating circumstance means Freddy Castro must bring this spring some bonus box bounce. So getting Freddy ready brightens any outlook. It also unmasks the fundamental fact about Austin McDowell's impact.
Chest protector, you just beat it right in front of him. So you gotta attack the ones in the dirt short, right?
Besides that obvious key position depth concern, all the diamond basic tactics are coach-covered daily topics.
Get out of it.
Ear-piercing screams are rare, of course.
More and back! All right, there's a difference, all right?
You're good.
Got three.
Tag it.
Back. Got it.
And we're two.
Usually just Tony the tutor, encouraging common sense competition IQ.
Just worked on over there. Just giving a big target, getting ready to make a throw. So if we're following our throw and moving our feet, pitching the ball with our feet, we're going to be a lot better off in that situation. And then everybody should be talking all the way through.
While filling in fielding details.
Those of y'all that are not used to talking, you don't talk, that's not good for your team. So you need to get in the habit. I remember roaming a little bit. I had to come out there and work with the other rookies a little bit. Then I'll come out there and work with y'all. John, talk a little bit. Everybody needs to be talking, kind of. Everybody needs to be talking, right?
Share!
Good talk.
Yeah!
Why do outfielders need a boat? No bunt defenses.
No.
Because you're backing up different things, all right? So you need to know bun defense is one through four, and you need to know what you're doing on first and third situation. All that's on the PowerPoint. Piercy made PowerPoint with technology 10 years ago. It was impressive. I've never been more proud of myself for it. Got a little stick figure, man, moving around. What's that? Huh? It looks like a third grade, but it has, for every one of them, it says first base, second base, third base, shortstop, outfielders, catcher, wherever, pitchers, where they go. It tells you where to go, so there's no gray area in there. Good, buddy?
Rapping about running.
Get your signs, check your outfield. Like I was just telling them, if there's a pull hitter up, right center field, right fielder playing right center, it's a pitch run down the right field line. We don't have to worry about it because we know the outfielder's not going to get it, right? Knowing where people playing is very important. If you know the left fielder's playing shallow and he crushes one, you're at first base, you can come all the way, read it while you're going and see what's going on. So it's very important to do that. It's also very important to make sure you got the signs and everybody's on the same page. It's very important that we understand what the reason is. A, force play, you're probably going to be in an A with 0-1 out, all right? Nobody, or two outs or nobody on first, we're probably going to be in a C, all right? Most more often than not. All right, last year, I sat over there in the third base coaching box and screamed for y'all to get bigger secondaries, all right? I screamed and screamed, hey, bigger secondary, and then we'll be here, we're doing this, and then we get out here, pitch is thrown, and we're like this. All right, that guy's not going to throw back there. So we should be able to get out here and have an aggressive secondary every pitch. Have an aggressive secondary every pitch, and then we're like, ball's hit, boom, we're rolling. If we do that every pitch, then we're going to have a better chance to score on every time a ball's hit. All right? Shouldn't be a whole lot of thinking. We should be better at secondaries and base running all the way around. Because we gave up a lot of runs and a lot of outs last year not doing things at that look. When something happens, you know you're gonna get first base. A lot of people are like, okay, I got first base. I wanna dap my coaches up and do all that. I want everybody to see that. No, once you know you're gonna have first, your ultimate goal is to get a second, and so on and so forth. So we're taking big turns, big aggressive turns. We're reading dirt balls. We're trying to get a second. What happens when we read a dirt ball, we take a base? All right, we got a man scoring position. What happens to your team tomorrow? Hey, great job. Hey, good read, baby. Good read. What happens to them?
Goes down.
All right, what else happened? They can no longer do what? Turn double play. We just did a lot of things in that. We took a little bit of momentum our way, looked like a baseball team our way, and took them out of double play situation. So now, next ball is a base hit, or next ball is a ground ball to the second baseman, right? Simple baseball, next ball is a ground ball to the second baseman, instead of being a double play, now we have a man in third and scoring position, pass ball, we score. Or if there's one out of that time, pop fly, we score. Where otherwise, we're sitting there, we give up a double play, we're out of the inning. They throw 8 pitches instead of 15 pitches. We get 0 runs instead of 1. We're to be doing that at all times. All right? How far they are. Ball's hit deep to right field. Where am I going? We know he's probably going to catch it. You get back here. What are you looking at?
You
can look there until you know it's about 20 feet, like 80, 100 feet, 2 seconds, a second and a half. Then you're looking at me. I'll be right here. When I drop my hand, you come. Because if you're looking like this, now it's a little bit on you. Probably going to get a little antsy, leave a little early, and it's going to take you a little bit longer to turn and go. So I want you here. Boom, I'll drop my hand. We'll go. We got our secondary. We just flip and watch what's going on. If we see them getting under it, we get back. If we see them struggling like that, we build, and we can score. College baseball, I know if at high school level, there's a lot of big toads out there. So we want to make sure we're doing that. So we always want to be aggressive. When in doubt, do what?
Look at you.
Take your coach. We're going to be telling you what to do the whole time, all right? Ground ball right to the third base, and we're busting home, picking up the coach, and we can score a lot easier. Base hits, different type things going on with two more balls. It's called base on balls. Not called a walk, because we're sprinting down to the first base. All right? Oh, it looks stupid. No, it doesn't look stupid. We're sprinting down to first base. Why? Why are we sprinting? We're not sprinting through the bag. We're sprinting down to first base. Now what do we have the option of doing?
Take seconds.
Ball's in the dirt. He's lazy going back to get it. We can take second. Man on third. We have a play where we can just keep right on running. Pitcher's got the ball. Now they have to make a decision. All right? He either throws it all the way through. We score that run there. Or we get second base.
Preaching, pitching poise.
All right, so that way, if you go like that, he calls it a ball, now what have you just done? You just showed the umpire up, right? So the next close call, what do you think is going to happen? You're not going to get it. So, mound presence, composure. You work on doing what you can do. Let him do his job, you do your job. All right?
Promoting developmental devotion.
We're seeing more and more good things every day. Saw some good things today. We're going to put the 9 out there that are bought in that we can trust to do things. All right. So I'm not going to go home after losing a 3-2 game because somebody thought they could do something on their own. That I've been doing this. He's been doing this. He's been doing this. Been around, and we see certain things. If somebody decides they want to steal second or steal third in the 3-2 game gets thrown out and we weren't doing that, and the next pitch we were bunting, now guess what? We just lost a 3-2 game. Why? Be a baseball player, be instinctual, but don't make things up. All right, does that make sense?
Yes, sir.
I promise you, if there's ever a situation, ask the guys that have been around a while, if there's ever a situation where I did not prepare you before it happened in a game, I will apologize in the huddle after the game. I promise you, you're gonna be knowledgeable of pretty much any situation that is going to arise in a baseball game. All right. If you listen, if you're a sponge, if you do that kind of stuff. They're out here because the same reason I'm out here. All right. I want y'all to be successful. I want y'all to have a positive experience. Okay. So in order to do that, I promise you, if you jump on the train, jump on the bus and just roll and just accept the things that we're talking about and just say, hey, let me try that and do it the way we're trying to get everybody on board. Then we can spend more time getting better at baseball and less time with other things. All right. Different level. Promise you, those of y'all that have never played varsity baseball, when we play against a quality baseball team, the speed of the game is substantially faster than what you're used to, what you're used to doing. All right. So some of the things you can do on bases and Rocky Mountain in a Top Gun tournament, you're not going to be able to do on a varsity baseball field without getting made look crazy. All right. That makes sense. So just know that, all right?
Activating existing philosophies and freshman faces during a problem address rehearsal proved.
Yeah, get away!
I'm not the one who is.
He ain't that one too.
Throw your back.
Hard beans grow tough guys. Certainly implanted this hit squad with unified unflinchability. Outstanding. Counter at-bat attacks might even explain the collective raw rage toward the approaching Rawhide. Much my talent hit the offensive switch doing a Broughton beatdown for sure. For score.
Yeah.
Strong, flattering swings elevate early East Waken expectations. Definitely no long shot in the dark to picture more blue skies overhead again. Cooperation, camaraderie, plus cohesion ought to be the main optimism reason. Because prize fight for flight plans will never fall apart. If the playmakers follow a partner. I'm Don Fuller, East Wake Television.